You want to know what's going on in West Texas? You want the morning drive. News Talk 550 KCRS.
Good morning and welcome to your morning drive. News Talk 550 KCRS. We're the voice of West Texas. I'm Chris Moore.
And I'm Spencer Bennett.
And joining us on the phone line, Dr. Richard Bartlett. Good morning, sir.
Good morning, Chris. Good morning, Spencer. I'm so glad to be with you. And the listeners are going to hear not just what's happening in West Texas, but what's happening in the world right now.
Well, there is a lot going on. And you're going to talk about a particular subject that I actually heard about this morning on my way, right while I was getting ready for work this morning. So I'm fascinated to hear what you have to say about it. So it has to do with Joe Rogan, his show, and a particular, quote, expert on COVID.
Yeah, so Joe Rogan, of course, very popular podcaster, and he had this medical expert, Dr. Hotez, which is from Baylor, Houston, and he has been the expert on MSNBC, CNN, all the main networks for replacing Fauci. As that voice promoting the COVID shots and constantly putting out the latest message.
Propaganda.
Not science or facts, but message. And so he actually was on Joe Rogan's show where Joe Rogan interviewed him. And so Dr. Hotez, so there's a fellow, RFK Jr., that has challenged Dr. Hotez to a debate, public debate, to just talk about science and talk about the facts, the evidence that's out now. And Dr. Hotez, of course, is the expert that is always called on for Good Morning America and all these shows constantly for 3 years. So he should be really comfortable to talk about this stuff.
You would think.
Joe Rogan offered $100,000 to the charity of Dr. Hotez's choice, and immediately other people started contributing to it because they wanted to hear the truth come out publicly. And so it's now up to $1.5 million and counting because others are constantly adding to it. The public's adding to the fund just because they want to hear the information. And Dr. Hotez is running in terror, apparently, because he refuses to help the needy people that could benefit from this in a charity. $1.5 million could do a lot of good.
Yeah.
But all he's got to do is show up and talk about what he's been promoting for the last 3 years. But he hasn't so far, and I'm going to make a prediction that he never does.
Well, everything he has just been backing, from mask don't work to the fact that if you take the vaccine, you won't get COVID. Well, we know that that's everything that he backed the last 3 years has come back and been proved false.
Well, there's when you put it all together, what he said in a montage where he's saying, get the shot and we'll be over. And then he goes, well, the first shot is not going well. It's two shots. And then he goes, three shots. And they put it back to back. He's up to five shots in the montage.
Right.
And so you can even see the Don Lemon and other interviewers' eyes rolling. They're even fatigued in the montage. But what would he be running from? The evidence now, breaking news, in the agency that oversees all vaccines, they just had their international conference, and a fellow who was involved in the human genome study and has 50,000 publications on just this subject of vaccines, he presented a 3.5-minute presentation that I'm going to send to you, Chris, so you can put it on the website for KCRS.
Okay.
And he said, look, this is how we make these messenger RNA vaccines. We do this process to first make the artificial messenger RNA code, and then we go to another process to mass produce. That second mass production process involves plasmids with DNA in it for that code going into E. coli bacteria, and the E. coli pump out tons of messenger RNA code for the spike protein, and that's how we mass produce these vaccines. He said that that's the process. We know that. The problem is, he said, I studied in his lab the vaccines from multiple lots, and there's a tremendous amount of DNA in plasmids in the messenger RNA vaccines, and that's not supposed to be in there.
Wow.
It's not purified.
Mm.
That's a problem that people are being told that they're getting messenger RNA, but what he uncovered is that there's DNA contamination in it, in plasmids. Now, that's a whole other level of trouble, because that allows DNA to get put in DNA.
Right.
And so it's not, there's actually a threshold of what they consider safe, and it's like 1,000 times that level of DNA in the messenger RNA shots, according to this gentleman who is an expert. So this is shocking, breaking news.
So what would the side effects be? So you've got these DNA particles that are 1,000 times over what your body can handle. What would be some of the side effects from that? What would that cause?
The obvious concern is that DNA can get incorporated, that genetic code in the DNA can get incorporated in the DNA of the person that it gets put in.
Mm-hmm.
That's a problem. And so that's a whole nother level of genetic engineering where you could, and that's what happens to the E. coli. It gets permanently incorporated in the DNA.
Mm-hmm.
So if that was to happen to humans, we don't know if that permanently changes their genetic code. Are they permanently going to be making spike protein on some low level from now on, which is actually the toxin, which actually is what causes the disease,
right?
Which would be a problem. So this is breaking news. It's not supposed to have been able to happen. This fellow showed that they were not purifying the messenger RNA. We were told, don't worry, because it's messenger RNA. That can't get incorporated in your DNA. Well, this is a big problem because it's contaminated, according to this gentleman, and that is DNA that's being put in people's bodies.
Now, Dr. Bartlett, do we know whose plasmoids these happen to be that are we don't know, do we?
So, yeah, the term is plasmids.
Plasmids, sorry.
So, yeah, plasmid. So any doctor or nurse will understand that that's something that is one of the mechanisms to put DNA, to encode DNA into another organism.
Mm.
So anyways, that's a problem. Here's another thing that he might not want to talk about, that the University of Basil in Switzerland showed that 3 out of 100 people have heart cells die after they get COVID shots in their study. 3 out of 100. That doesn't mean they die. That just means they had heart cells die. And that it showed up in this one blood test that I, as an ER doctor at a heart hospital, look for heart attacks, called troponin. Their troponin levels are elevated. That's only in healthy heart cells. It's not in the bloodstream unless heart cells die and spill it into the bloodstream. And so 3 out of 100 have that. That might explain another thing. How come they're slipping trimethamine, a heart medicine, into children's COVID shots? Maybe they're trying to keep them from having heart trouble.
Oh, my gosh.
We're starting to see things connect after the fact 3 years later. So, Chris, do you think that guy's ever going to show up for the debate?
You know, Dr. Bartlett, I hate to say anything that could be proven wrong, but I feel pretty 100% he will not show.
What do you think, Chris?
I don't think so.
Oh, no, he's not going to show. I mean, the more evidence that comes out, you know, they said, oh, well, COVID gives you myocarditis, and it turns out it's a shot or something along those lines.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, this is scary stuff.
We have
it really is.
Yeah, we have congressmen, politicians, presidents if they had investments in Pfizer, Moderna, or Johnson & Johnson stock,
mm-hmm.
Do you think that they'd be quick to say that there's a problem when they're cashing in on this? Actually, if people look on the internet, they're going to find out that a lot of the congressmen that they know really close are invested in Johnson & Johnson, Pfizer, and Moderna. And wouldn't that be something if a president that says, I'm losing my patience with the American people, you just need to get your shot, If that president had stock in that, or any other president, would that be a conflict of interest?
I would believe it would be.
Yeah, that's goes back to that thing knowingly in the law.
Yeah. A conflict of interest is the word.
Yeah.
And anyways, we got a lot going on, and that's probably why Peter Hotze, the infectious disease guru who's been talking constantly about get your shot, it's mm-hmm. going to be long lasting, and then, oh, well, it's not long lasting, get two shots, and that's long lasting. Oh, wait, it's not long lasting, you need to get three shots, and that'll do it. Oh, wait, that's not long lasting, you need four, and now he's up to five.
Right.
And actually he went beyond that, and he's saying that you need to get multiple ones every couple. He says it looks like you're going to need to get a booster every couple months, which is his latest advice.
Doctor, that's just crazy, and I'm sorry we're running out of time.
We are out of time. Thank you. Thank you for keeping us updated with breaking news, and we want to thank you for everything you do. Have a wonderful day. I know you're working ER today, so thanks for making time for us.
God bless you all, and God bless Texas.
God bless Texas and Dr. Richard Bartlett. Well, we do have to take a quick break. It's time to go into your Sean Hannity Morning Minute, Fox News, and TSN Sports.